How are we doing, guys? This is Tim. I finally got this video right now. It's a little bit late at night and I'm not very busy right now. Alright, so this video is actually a viewer request, my first viewer request, on how to install the rail segments on the APS Guardian 112. It's mostly because of the rail transform system. It's a little bit of a funky system, if you guys aren't familiar with it, and it's a little bit difficult with on the gun. Alright, first of all, what I do anyways is I take off the top receiver, which is very easy. Just take the pin, punch it out, top receiver comes off, put the lower receiver away, take out the barrel so that just doesn't fall out. Trying to get some moisture out of the inside of my outer barrel. It's gonna be fun. Alright, so you need your top receiver like this. So what you're gonna do, you're obviously gonna have your rail segments and your screws and your Allen key to tighten those on. You're gonna start with the bottom piece, the part that goes on the inside of the weapon. So what you're gonna do, you see the ridges on the inside, you wanna put those on the inside. So what you're gonna do, you can take it, slide it through this notch between the fake gas tube and the rail. Kind of slide, actually, sorry. Take the flip up sight, put it up, slide it in. All right, there we go. All right, now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna install it on the bottom. It's one of the more difficult spots to get it. See if I can get it on the bottom here. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna kind of jiggle it around until you kind of get it to the desired spot. Actually can't do it on the bottom. I'm gonna go over that in a second. Why you can't do it exactly right there. So I'm gonna do it on the side. You want it down, like I have it right now. You can't really see it, but the grooves actually lock into place. So if you just kind of lay it down like that, and then what I like to do, since I have that spot, put over real quick. Kind of keep it where I want it to be. I'm gonna take my rail segment, I'm gonna put it on here to the desired spot, and then I'm gonna take a little piece of duct tape and I'm gonna tape it on like that. There we go. It avoids a third hand, which most people don't have, so I figure I'd do that and flip it back over again. Now I'm gonna I can use my own head, kind of slide the inner piece kind of back to where I want it. This is not easy, I have to admit. This is definitely one of the harder ways to do it. Sorry about the camera. Alright, it's kind of, come on you. The inner piece is stuck on the stupid sight. Oh gosh. Come on. There we go. Once again, I apologize for the camera angle. Alright, well, this is going to take me a very long time. So basically, what you're going to do, you're going to take it, take your screws, you're going to put them up, you know, keep the, obviously, the piece down. Then you're going to, I kind of got it wedged right now, but you're going to take it, screw it in, and then once you have the first one in, it's a lot easier to get the second one in. So to get that first screwed in, it's a lot easier. Now, I'm going to go over kind of a different way. So you have your gun right there. I did see these scratch marks on the suppressor. I was able to get it off. The glue is pretty tough. Now what I've done, easiest way to do this is to actually remove the handguard. So what you do, you see the three screws right there. Take this and unscrew these guys. I don't want to lose these. They are small and very, very, very light, and they fly quickly. And screw that guy. All right. Then what you're gonna do? You're gonna flip the sight back up again. Let me get this piece out. Kind of reverse of how you got it in there. Kind of have to angle it upward again. Don't cut that out yet. I mean, I can definitely see where people are coming from saying this is difficult. It is not easy. Especially with the longer ones. The smaller ones are a little bit easier to do, but the longer ones are a little bit harder to get out. Let me get that hole. Probably be able to do it a little bit. Come on, you. Okay, well, that will come out anyways. Alright, so what you're going to do, you're going to slide this forward once you get the screws off, like that, bam, very easy. And then, what I actually did, there's actually a pin, there's a pin holding in the gas tube. Let's see if I can get, here we go, a smaller key, kind of punch that out, just a little pin, comes straight out, take that. Loosen that up here. Okay, there we go. So this is a little bit looser and easier to work with. You need to take this, and this whole thing actually screws right off. I'm just going to have to tight screw it off. That releases from the top receiver. You have your whole barrel. Now this doesn't come off the end. So now what you're going to need to do, you actually need to take, I'm sorry, this is very elaborate how to do this. They obviously did not think of the normal person, you know, doing this. So what you're going to take, you're going to take your rail system, you put it back into the grooves, and the whole thing's going to slide out the back like that. And there's the other rail piece, go right out. Alright, so now you have a problem, because you have to get that right out. You have to get the suppressor off. Now what I did, I heated up some water on the stove, not to boiling, so don't let it boil. I don't know if it's going to really do any damage to this metal, but I just want to let it boil. You know, you can burn your hand or something like that, so I wouldn't do that. I almost did burn my hand doing it. What I did was take two wrenches, grab each end, kind of press it into, you know, the table, and then just kind of crank it open. Remember, these are, you know, lefty-tighty, righty-loosey, so don't do that or else you'd be cranking your thing the wrong way. Alright, so I've already done this, so this is going to be a lot easier to get off. Obviously, I've already done it, so got it off. Now, there was kind of like a blocker piece. I'm guessing the reason why they did it is just so they can hide the barrel a little bit more. So I'm going to take this off. This is metal, so it's pretty heavy. Now, there was a blocker piece right there. It's just a piece of plastic with a spring. Kind of difficult to get off, so I just took it off and didn't deal with it because I am going to take off this front sight post right now. Which are just, if you can't see, they're just two little Allen heads. Pretty much, they're the same size as the screws for the actual rail system. Makes it a little bit easier, you don't have to keep swapping out tools. And once again, don't really want to lose these. If you can't tell them apart, they're slightly longer than the ones from the rail system. I noticed, like about a thread or two longer. So, just slightly. So once you got off, like I said, that blocker piece, whole thing's just going to slide off. And now, with this piece off, with this is so dumb, because they put this on. When you have it on the rail system, you can't install any of the rail pieces below it. And you just can't do it. There's not enough gap in between the rail system and the sight right here. There's no gap right there. You can't, you know, on both angles, you can't get it in there. So I'm not sure what they were thinking. I know the two other ASRs did not have this on. They had the flip-up sight on the front rail. I'm not sure why they just didn't keep the flip-up sight. I mentioned that in my first video. I'm just going to take off and leave off. So now this is going to be a lot easier. So what you can do here, you can take your rail system. Look at that. It's already off. So I'm going to put mine on the bottom, where I want it, because that's how I am. I'm a customer. I want to put my rail system where I want it. And I want to, you know, put a foregrip. I want to do something with the bottom. So I'm going to slide that on. Like, there's grooves right there. Very easy to slide on. You take it. You can just hold it with your finger. Take your rail system. Apply it where you want to. Take your screw. First screw here. And I have to get it in there. This is the big one. And there we go. You just don't want to tighten everything down until I got both screws on. Right. There we go. I said this isn't possible with that SSM type sight on the front. It just isn't. You can't get it on there. And they just didn't leave enough space on the rail, I guess. I don't know what they were thinking. And there you go. Now the bottom rail is on there. Now, it's a lot easier to put back on the gun without this up because you don't have to worry about putting it on backwards. You just can put it on the front way. Like that. So all you have to do, take the piece, screw it back onto your upper receiver. Crank it a little bit more. There we go. Now you see the original marks right there. Try to line them up with the pinhole. Make sure it's even. I try to look at it like that, you know, make sure it's even. There we go, like that. Rail system. Make sure it's in the grooves. Make sure it's all lined up. You can kind of tighten it down, the whole thing moves. And then you just reinstall your three little pins. And like I said before, this wouldn't be possible with that S-System sight on it. So I really don't know what APS was thinking. They're usually generally fairly good about knowing what the customer wants. And, you know, what is practical. And they definitely did not do this with this system, for at least this version, you know, the 112, because of that stupid sight. So you have to take off the whole suppressor just to get the darn sight off. It's like, that's just ridiculous. I don't see why that's necessary. But, you know, things are difficult like that. Once again, guys, I'm sorry for the length of this video. I knew this was going to take a long time. So, I, you know, just prepare for it anyways. Can't get that. Don't want a cross thread. There we go. All right. It's on there nice and tight. Not going anywhere. Suppressor back on. Like I said, I took off that blocker piece. I would recommend, because that thing is just a pain. It's a piece of stupid plastic. And just... And this type is just fine without that blocker piece, so what's the point? There we go. Slide it back in. All right. Now I did notice... Oh. I did forget something very important to put back to my gun. Thing called a barrel. You know, this piece. I said, it's kind of late at night. I'm sorry, guys. Okay, get the barrel back in. Right. There we go. Back in there. Put the charging handle on upside down. There we go. Definitely not the most...